Hello everyone, we are at Epcot again. They say that a third time is a charm. I really hope so, because I want to see if finally I get to go around World Showcase and take a look at the Food and Wine Festival. Also, the last time that I was here, which was a week ago, they didn't have any of the Food and Wine Festival merchandise. They were still trying to sell the Flower and Garden merchandise, and cast members said that they were expecting the Food and Wine Festival merchandise anytime now, so crossing fingers that they have it now. And this time around, we're just gonna go straight to World Showcase and see the food offerings. Very excited about that. I also wanted to show you my ears. These are the Betsy Johnson ears. I forgot to show them to you when I was filming the video of my my ears collection. I don't know how that happened. I mean, no, I do know. These are designer ears, so they come in their own special box, so I don't keep them with the rest of my ears. And I'm also carrying my Dooney Walk in the Park bag, and I have the matching magic band. So, feels good. I love how colorful these construction walls are and that they incorporated some of the characters. So we have Hey Hey here, and then if we walk a little bit towards World Showcase, we have Edna Mode. This side has all the lands, and on the wall in front we have more characters, and I can't remember their names, but I know they are from Finding Dory. And Crush, Squirt, Nemo, and ooh, what's her name? Can you spot Hank? Right there at the top corner. Hey, hey, is that you again? And ooh, scary. Pua. Pua is the cutest. Oh, his face. He's just adorable. Hey, hey seems to be everywhere. Moana. And Mr. Ray is the last one that we find here. We're in front of the Journey into Imagination, and the construction wall here is full of figments. As we are heading towards World Showcase, I find Miguel and Dante here, and then I have the Frozen characters. And that's funny because the first pavilion that we encounter is Mexico, and then Norway. It is starting to rain, which is really bad news, because if it really does rain, I have to put my camera inside my bag and I can't film. I don't want that to happen. And also, I checked before coming here when I was choosing what bag to wear, and it said that it wasn't going to rain, which is why I chose this Dooney. So now it has some raindrops, and that discolors the leather. On my last video, we went to the left, to the Mexico Pavilion. So this time we're heading towards Canada, to the right. But I think I'm gonna have to stop at that store to seek some shelter from the rain. The rain has stopped, but apparently it's impossible for me to go into a store and not buy something. So I wanna show you what I got. It's just one thing. I couldn't help it. I've wanted this mask since I saw it. Maybe like a month ago, the first time I saw somebody wearing it, I knew I just had to have it. $6. They don't seem to have extra large masks anywhere, so I went with a large. And this might be a better fit just because the extra large, which is the one that I'm wearing right now, goes too high. Like, it touches my lashes, my bottom lashes, and it bothers me. So maybe this one is going to be better. I'm hoping. Even if it's not, I just have to use it because it's adorable. And while I am showing you things, I'm wearing my shoelace charms for the first time. I decided to have Minnie Mouse on one shoe and then Mickey Mouse on the other, and I am loving these. Just one thing, if Disney ever sees this, maybe you should do them in a way that you can attach them and then take them off easily, because I had to undo the laces to be able to put them in, because it's like something you thread. You thread the lace through the little loop here on the back, and yes, that is more secure, but it would be better if it had a different kind of latch so that you can like just attach it and then take it off later without having to take the shoelaces off. Shimmer and Sips is the first booth that I find. So let's look at the menu. They have a soft serve that sounds amazing because it's shimmering, and some banana bread pudding, but what did I just say? Just plant-based banana bread. Unfortunately, I can't have any of that because none of it is keto. And that is where they have the Starbucks now. The citrus blossom is here, and this is where you can get orange bird sipper cup. And this is the menu for the citrus blossom. So let's see, lobster tail. I don't eat shellfish, so I'm not eating that. But if I did, I think that would be a keto acceptable option. Then the crispy citrus chicken. I don't know, the crispy part, and the orange. Yeah, I don't think that one is good because I'm sure it has sugar, and then I'm sure they make it crispy with some kind of carb. So no, it sounds very appealing to me though, but I have to be good, especially because I had rice this morning. Then orange cream shake, that's what you get when you buy the orange bird sipper cup. Hawaii has such a beautiful booth with all the flowers. So here's the menu, and the slider I've had before and it is absolutely amazing, but again, I can't have that. And then there's teriyaki glazed spam hash. It has potatoes, peppers, onions, and spicy mayonnaise. So because of the potatoes, I can't have it. And I know it sounds crazy that I'm trying to find something that I can eat when I'm following the keto lifestyle, but yeah, I mean, I don't want to cheat. So I'm only eating something if it's keto friendly-ish. I know that nothing will probably be completely keto here, but I want to try. All right, here's Canada. So they have Canadian cheddar and bacon soup. That sounds really good. It comes with a pretzel roll that obviously I can't have. And then they have the Le Cellier wild mushroom beef filet mignon, and I can't have that one. Yeah, I think so. I mean, I'm not sure how many carbs are in mushrooms, but I don't know. Feels like I can have both if I don't eat the pretzel roll. Still selling flower and garden. And right as I was crossing Canada, I found this building and people were coming in. It didn't say anything, so I decided to come and check it. And look at this. This is so pretty. There's more food and wine festival options in here. So let's check them out. This is super cool. I'm excited to see what they're offering here. First booth here is Festival Favorites. And I think this is what they're offering. So they have kielbasa and potato pierogi, seafood fisherman's pie, spanakopita from Greece. And then they have some wine. I don't drink alcohol, so I'm not sure if everything there is wine, but I'm assuming. And then they have Guinness Bailey's milkshake. I would try that. And water. Desserts and champagne is next. Oh, this is where you get the liquid nitro chocolate cake pops. And another one served with crumbled twigs. And then another one with crushed M&Ms. Oh, keto. Wrong time to be on keto. Appleseed Orchard, and they have a charcuterie and cheese plate and caramel apple popcorn, and all the beverages. Mac and cheese, a whole booth dedicated to mac and cheese. So they have the gourmet one, which is served with boursin, garlic, and fine herb cheese sauce topped with herb panko. Then the buffalo chicken macaroni and cheese, lobster, and the last one is served with house-made Italian sausage and peppers. And those are the beverage options. So far, if I decide to have something, it's going to be something from Canada. It's the only thing that I've found that I think is keto friendly-ish. But still undecided because honestly, I had a really big lunch, so I'm pretty full. We'll see how it goes as the day progresses, and maybe by nighttime I might feel hungry. We'll see. Very nice and cozy environment in here, but let's head out to see what else is there around World Showcase. Look what I find as I'm coming out! How lucky of me! Hi! Oh, thank you! Ears. So how lucky was that? Oh, and they waved and everything. I mean, he loved my ears. That made my day. You know, I missed Donald, who was the only one who wasn't there. I mean, I guess you can also say that Daisy wasn't there. But out of the Fab Five, he was the only one missing. Why? Celebrating 25 years. That's awesome. And this is France. Let's see what Remy brings us. I'm not even gonna try to pronounce that. Let me just leave it there for you to pause the video and take a look at it. Oh, it's in English under, never mind. It's goat cheese tart with caramelized onions on a flaky pastry crust. Oh, that sounds amazing. And then braised duck confit à l'orange with mashed sweet potatoes, and then brioche cake filled with light pastry cream and served with raspberry coulis. Somebody correct me, I don't know if I'm saying that right. Not keto. Brazil. They have crispy pork belly and the Brazilian cheese bread. So let me see, served with black beans, tomato and onions. I've heard conflicting things about black beans. Some people seem to think that if you're following keto, you shouldn't eat them, but then other people say that they are acceptable. I don't know. I'm assuming that if you are doing lazy keto, then black beans are acceptable. I don't know. The tomato and onions also add a few carbs, but I don't know how much they give you, so probably not that many carbs. So that could be a good option. I still think that Canada is winning for me. And here's the menu for Morocco. Nothing in here is keto, but everything looks good, really good. I would like everything here, hopefully next year. Here they have a display to see what they look like. This is a chocolate baklava and the spicy hummus fries and the beef kefta pockets. I thought they didn't have the spirit jersey anymore. It's the first booth where I see it. It's so pretty. And that is the front. I was just told by a cast member that the Food and Wine Festival merchandise will be released tomorrow. So by the time you're watching this video, it'll be out. Japan menu. So they have teriyaki chicken bun, frothy ramen, and what is that, Kira? Okay, it says fresh cut salmon, salmon roe, I don't even know what that means, and spinach over sushi rice, a sprinkle with whatever that is, and topped with poke sauce, poke? Yeah, clearly I know nothing about their food. yeah, nothing that I can have here. Again, like I said before, maybe next year. I think next year I'm still going to be following the keto lifestyle, but I'll probably be at the size and weight that I want, and then I'll be able to relax a little bit more and eat those things without feeling guilty. Yeah. Hobson Barley at the US. They have New England lobster rolls, southern seafood boil, and freshly baked carrot cake. Carrot cake is the only thing that sounds good to me just because I don't like seafood. But it's not keto. Look at what they have at this store. The Poor Unfortunate Souls. That one is $95. Stitch, $140. I thought it was gonna be more. Yago, $80. Genie, $140. Sleeping Beauty, $140. Donald, I love this one, so colorful, $140. This is my favorite, $160. Not a bad price. Ooh, that one. I spoke too soon. That, I don't know which one is my favorite. I love them both. I need them both. Look at this Pluto by Brito. Does he have a prize? How pretty is this? Very fitting to have it here at this store. I had never seen this spirit jersey and it has fireworks. Did this come out for the 4th of July? I don't remember seeing this. It says America the Beautiful Epcot World Showcase. Pretty. Oh, I don't think I've ever mentioned how much I love Bomba. Oh, this is precious. It doesn't have a price. Look how they did the hitchhiking ghosts. They're like translucent. Very good job. $75 for this Doom Buggy. The Gallery of Light. These are all the options. They range from $79.99 to $100. Wonderful. Love this one. I'm loving this Mickey Sorcerer. The nose is glittery. And look, I found the prizes. So Pluto, $75. I think that because the parks are so crowded usually, I'm noticing things that I had never seen. And there's a tree, and it seems to have some fruit, but I don't know what that is. A couple of them have fallen down there. Can you see that? So it looks like oranges. Are they? I don't know. Somebody please tell me if you know. And we have the menu for Italy. And obviously, I mean, I knew there wasn't going to be anything keto here, but I just had to look. And also, I wanted to show you the menu. Since they don't have the physical copies anymore, it might be a good idea for you to, you know, make a list of the things that you might want to try when you come over. Looks fantastic. That Classica tortellini, oh, sounds amazing. Well, it turns out that this whole time I was wearing my mask upside down and I hadn't noticed until somebody thankfully pointed it out, and now it's the right way. Germany, let's see what they have here. Okay, pasta, I know I can't. Pretzel, okay, so no. Nothing here for me, but maybe for you. Check it out. Does it make it to your list? Africa has some spicy vegan, Kenyan vegan corn and white beans. That has peas and quinoa, ancient greens medley, and kashumbari slaw. I'm sure I didn't say that right, but you know, you're reading it yourself. And some piri piri skewered shrimp. I'm assuming that's the sauce or the seasoning. I don't know. If I had seafood, that could probably be keto, except for the couscous. China has chicken dumplings, which sounds amazing, and I would probably have that if I weren't on keto. and beverages. Jasmine beer. That sounds interesting. Seems like I'm gonna have some time for some attractions, and I'm gonna start with Frozen. Wow. This is so pretty. And we're getting close to the end. This one is Mexico. I showed it on my last Epcot video, and I want both of those. I'm sure I'm gonna have them one day, even if they're not keto. Just not today, because I already cheated this morning with some rice. So yeah, I'm gonna have to pass on those today. And Earth Eats is the last stop. This is another menu that I showed on my last Epcot video, but here it is in case you didn't watch that video. That's it, we made it. It is true that third time is a charm. We were able to go around World Showcase and see all the menu offerings. I have been thinking about getting something from Canada, but honestly, I'm so full that it's not right. But now that I know my options, I know that for sure next time that I'm at Epcot, that's what I'm having. I think that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you took note of everything that you want to eat when you come to the festival. And I'll see you on the next video. Bye. So I have news. There's been an addition to the family. Mushu. Look. He's hanging on for his life. I love him. I needed that one. I was debating whether to get this one or Groot. This one won. I still want Groot, but that's gonna wait. It's gonna have to wait. I can't stop looking at the viewfinder because I love him.